Here's the problem. We need to add up all the numbers 1 through 100. In other words, 1 plus 2 plus 3, all the way up to 99 and 100. The mathematician Gauss solved this problem in just a few seconds, even as a young student. Here's how he did it. He quickly realized that the numbers 1 through 100 can be paired together in 50 pairs of 101 each. For example, he paired together the numbers 1 and 100 and added those together to get 101. He looked at the next numbers 2 and 99 and realized that those summed to 101 as well. He kept going, adding 3 and 98 to get 101, and he realized that this pattern would continue all the way up to 50 and 51, which would also give him 101. So he knew right away that with 50 pairs of 101, the sum of all the numbers 1 through 100 would turn out to just be 50, the number of groups that he had, multiplied by 101, and he did that multiplication problem to come up with the sum as 5,050. Now what we realize if we look at Gauss's rule is that we have two numbers multiplied together, and these are always going to follow a pattern that relates to the original sum of numbers we were asked to add. So we wanted to come up with the sum of 1 through 100. Well, if we call 100 n, and then we look at what this sum turned into in terms of the product here, 50 times 101, we notice that 50 is exactly half of 100. So 50, this number, is always going to come out to be n divided by 2, or n over 2. Same thing here, 101 is always going to be 1 more than that original number. This is always going to be n plus 1. So what we can conclude then is that no matter which set of numbers we're asked to add together, as long as we're starting with 1 and adding through a certain number, for example, add the numbers 1 through 60. Let's say we were given that example. We need to add 1 through 60. Well, we know that we need n divided by 2 and n plus 1. Well, we have 60 for the number n. So n divided by 2 would be 60 divided by 2, or 30. And we have n plus 1, or 60 plus 1. So n plus 1 would be 61. So what we can say then is that the sum of all the numbers 1 through 60 will be 30 times 61, which when we do the math, 30 times 61 is 1,830. And that's how we use Gauss's rule to find the sum of all the numbers 1 through n, no matter what the value of n might be.